So we're gonna take it into the
Game mode to creative, so then you can choose a book, which is a series. Yeah.
So we're gonna be kind of creating different mobs.
We're gonna basically recreate those dragons.
Aotearoa is New Zealand, and Aotearoa is where our Māori culture resides. All indigenous cultures are wrapped up with many facets, and all of those things together are what make that indigenous culture what it is. Te reo Māori is a national language of New Zealand, along with sign language and English, and it's usually the starting point for a lot of people when learning about te reo Māori. My hometown, we were raised very much in te reo Māori. We had quite a bush upbringing, I suppose. It was more of an immersive experience. These things are just sort of things you know, and there's no real import to them. And then I had kids, and I realised I needed to sort of transmit some of this information, some of this cultural knowledge I had.
Hi kaka, are you guys excited for today?
The very first time we played Minecraft, I guess that was the first sort of inkling of the idea that games could be a good space for learning.
So does everyone know what mobs are?
But the opportunity we saw was to create another immersive world. Only this time it wasn't the Minecraftian universe, it was the Māori universe.
We use the New Zealand curriculum. It's based primarily on the concept of building learning power and the principles around the Treaty of Waitangi. It makes us a little bit different from the rest of the world. It empowers our Māori students because it recognises the unique place of te ao Māori here in New Zealand. And as Kiwis, here at Newlands, we take that really, really seriously.
Our parent community has been really supportive of their kids learning in this way, and they understand and see the fact that collaboration and negotiation are an important part of life.
I didn't fully realise what the kids are capable of doing, how much learning they could do, and where it could actually lead to as well. You know, this is only the start of many opportunities and avenues for the kids in the future.
Really just unleash your creativity and your imagination.
In my class, their focus is, can you create your own knowledge? Can you make your own plan and see it through? And can you get yourself unstuck?
This is our world. There's a couple of things you might notice straight off the bat.
Seeing teachers see their students get inspired and then them getting inspired by something like a computer game, that's pretty cool.
I want to check that you've got that comma down there, right?
We had to do a mashup, so we put two worlds together. Like, we could take something from the real world and put it into Minecraft, or take something from Minecraft and put it into the real world.
My group made a working cinema. We even managed to make an underground system of tunnels.
Normally in school, it's like, here's this, do this, off you go. But now it's like, blank schedule. Minecraft, yes please.
Well, we fully expect you guys to either add or augment the...
When Microsoft contacted us, asking us if we'd like to develop something in te ao Māori for Minecraft Education Edition, what we saw was extremely exciting.
We are so excited that it is now available to every school student in New Zealand.
Minecraft is a universal language. There is barely a kid in New Zealand who hasn't heard of Minecraft. Kids love it. They absolutely adore it. We love it as teachers because of the collaborative opportunity it affords.
How did you guys manage?
Whetu's an innovator. He's seen the potential to use mahi maina to open te ao Māori to the rest of the world, changing our world here in Aotearoa, where te ao Māori is acknowledged.
So you gotta take a risk and a chance.
It's a safe place to make mistakes, and these kids need that, and they will make that mistake. There will be griefing, there will be arguments, there will be turf wars. It's important to give them that space, because with that conflict, you also give them the space to work it out.
Things on the outside of that space.
I think under all this talk that we're doing, we're talking about, you know, games and learning, like they're two, you know, really separate things. And I think one of the big philosophies that underpins a lot of Indigenous cultures, especially ones that are based around oral history, that things like games and learning are not two different worlds. They're the same thing. And so something like Minecraft, it isn't just the game, or you don't go in it just to learn, they're one and the same thing, right? So you engage with Minecraft, you're naturally learning. It's just one big learning platform.
It's nice to have your own freedom, and there isn't a teacher to tell you what to do and what not to do.
We can expect them to develop digital citizenship, to be responsible online, kind online, if we're not in those spaces where they can practice.
So I also changed one more block to look like a banana.
That's really empowering, I think, for tamariki, for kids. It's really empowering to give them a space where they can really be who they want to be.
Ko te manu e kai ana te miro, nōna te ngāhere, ko te manu e kai ana I te mātauranga, nōna te ao. The bird that eats of the middleberry owns the forest, but the bird that eats of knowledge owns the world. What Whetu has done has given everybody the opportunity to have an insight. I don't think it's just only for our kids, I think it's for everybody. It's to enlighten. The potential is endless.